Last video was quite the dry code reading and we are not done yet, but we are almost through. Please bear with me. This video is going to be a bit shorter. Last video, we looked at the pseudo source code as well as used GDB to investigate what this slightly confusing pointer copy loop does. Let's try to quickly summarize again. First, we allocate a buffer up here, the user args buffer. The size for this buffer is calculated by looping over the provided command line arguments, getting their string length plus 1 to account for the terminating null byte, and adding them all up. Our buffer is now large enough to hold all command line arguments. But the problem then happens next when we loop over the arguments again and copy them into this new buffer. We copy from the from pointer into the to pointer. So we copy from an address into another address, but we also check for backslashes, and in that case we skip one byte. Maybe you know that backslashes are often used to escape special strings. For example, if you have a string in Python and you want your string to contain double quotes as well, you need to escape that double quote. Otherwise, Python thinks this is the end of the string. And this loop is the reverse of it. It takes a string with escaped characters and unescapes them by removing them. And this is done by simply ignoring the backslash by incrementing the pointer, and then we copy the byte after the backslash. But if this backslash was now at the end of a string, right before the null byte, we would copy the terminating null byte and increment the from buffer further. Now we walked over the null byte into data coming after it. And suddenly the string length calculation from earlier doesn't match anymore, and we can copy more bytes than there is space in the user args buffer. So now we understand that. And the remaining two questions are, how do we get there? What are the conditions that have to be met? And why does it want to unescape strings here? What's the purpose? So let's explore that now. Anyway, there is still this curious reason why this only happens with sudo edit minus s and not any other random argument. Why specifically with minus s, and why with sudo edit and not plain sudo? Well, there are more conditions that need to be met in order to reach this code, and we can see that in this mode check. We only enter this unescape loop if the sudo mode is mode shell or mode login shell. And a bit of further up, we see that we also need to have mode run, mode edit, or mode check set. So let's search for these conditions. If we search for any occurrence where mode shell is set, we can find in the file parse args.c the big switch case statement for command line arguments. And minus s will set mode shell on flag. And mode login shell is set by minus i. Now, it is set on flag, not quite the sudo mode, but if you scroll all the way to the return, you can see that it returns mode ord with the flags. And in sudo.c, the main function, we can see that the return value of parse args is then the mode. So yes, setting the flags ultimately means we set the sudo mode. Anyway, let's just see what happens with those flags after the switch case. When we look further, here for example, it checks if mode login shell and mode shell is set. In that case, you get an error that you may not use minus i and minus s together. Anyway, let's look for more mode shell usage, and we can find this very curious loop with the command for shell mode. We need to rewrite argv. And a quick peek into the loop, we see that it escapes characters by adding a backslash when this if condition is true. So this seems to escape the arguments, while the later code here unescapes them. And the condition for this are almost the same. It will escape them if mode run and mode shell is set, and it will also unescape them when mode run is set as well as mode shell. But it will also unescape them in a few other conditions. So either we do not set mode shell, or we ensure that we don't set mode run. Okay, so let's explore option one. We do not set mode shell with minus s, but we set mode login shell with minus i. But actually, in this if, where it ensures not mode shell and mode login shell are not simultaneously set, if mode login shell is set, it will actually set mode shell right at the end. So we can't avoid setting mode shell. It will always be set by either minus s or minus i. So the only difference that remains now is mode run. If we can somehow not set mode run, but set mode edit or mode check, it should work. So how do we set mode edit? Well, right here near the start of parse args, if we execute as sudo edit, then the mode edit is set. But on second look, doesn't this check look weird? Check to see if we were invoked as sudo edit. Why not just string compare sudo edit? Well, this explains our minimal test case that we found through fuzzing. To check here, first does a string length on the prog name. So for example, sudo edit, or in our test case, zero edit, if it is longer than 4, it will string compare the prog name plus the length minus 4. So it will check the last 4 letters of the prog name. And so as long as the prog name is at least 5 characters and ends with edit, it will enter this mode. So this explains why we don't need it to be called sudo edit. Zero edit, blah edit, or pwn edit works. Isn't that an amazing pun? Pwned it or pwn edit? Qualys really dropped the ball on their marketing here. They should have called this vulnerability pwn edit. On Twitter, I reached out to the prestigious Zero Day Marketing Institute and suggested a name change. Let's see what happens. Anyway, now we understand why it works with sudo edit. So there's only one last question left. Why does it not work with sudo minus s? Is there a way to set mode edit or mode check with sudo? So the first option to set mode edit with sudo would be with minus e. But here it also writes the valid flags to mode non-interactive, which is very restrictive with the allowed flags and doesn't contain mode shell or mode login shell. So we can't use minus e. But there's one other way it could work. Could we set mode check? Here, so if mode is mode list, we set mode equal to mode check. So now can we set mode list with minus L? But this also sets the valid flags again, this time to mode non-interactive and mode login list. But those do not contain the needed mode shell or mode login shell. Okay, this was a lot of reading code. Not the most entertaining video, I guess, but at least now we understand how this vulnerability is triggered. Some code expected arguments to be escaped with a backslash, which kind of makes sense because they did get escaped, though there was this special condition when using sudoedit which skipped the original escaping but led to the later unescaping. And this mismatch led to the heap buffer overflow. Next video, I promise, will get more interesting because we can start working on the exploit.
I'm just stretching here to 8 minutes for the YouTube ads, so I guess subscribe.